Welcome you all to the Professor C.N.R. Rao Oration Award Lecture. This endowed lecture was instituted at the center in the year 2000. It was established with the generous contributions received from Bharat Ratna Professor C.N.R. Rao. It carries an honorarium. Thank you, Professor Rao, for your generous donation and also for being with us today. The lecture is usually given by a faculty member of the center. The first lecture in the year 2000 was delivered by Professor Amitabh Joshi. And I had the honor of receiving the award in the year 2006. And the last one in the series was during 2019, which was delivered by Professor Manisha Inamdar of MBGU. And we could not conduct the event last year, 2020, due to many uncertainties. I am pleased to announce that the Professor C.N.R. Rao Oration Award Lecture for this year is now being delivered by Professor A. Sundareshan, currently the Chair, CPMU. Professor Sundareshan joined JNCSR as a Faculty Fellow in 2004 and became a full professor in the year 2013. Brief on his background, he completed his PhD from IIT Bombay in 1994 and pursued his postdoctoral research at Laboratoire Crismat, France during 1995 to 1997. Later, he was an invited researcher at CNRS Grenoble and researcher of CREST JST at IAST Tsukuba before joining the center. Did I pronounce that correctly? The French name. Professor Sundareshan's current research interests are in chemistry and physics of transition metal oxides, with particular emphasis on superconductivity, magnetism, and multiphasicity. He has published more than 230 research articles, and he has, to his credit, there are many awards. I'll just read out few. He received MRSI and CRSI bronze medals, Sheikh Sarkar Career Award, National Prize for Research on Solid State and Materials Chemistry, MRSI, ICSE, and Material Science Annual Prize, as well as CRSI C.N.R. Rao National Prize in Chemistry for this year, 2021. He's also an elected fellow of the Indian Academy of Sciences, Bangalore. With this little introduction, particularly for the new students, I now welcome Professor Sundareshan to give the talk. Title of the talk is Frustration in Spin Systems, Emergent Phenomena. Sundar.
So I will remove this mask first. So thank you very much for your kind words, Professor Kulkarni. So it is indeed, it was a pleasant moment when Professor Kulkarni told me that I have been selected this year for Professor C.N.R. Rao Oration Award. And though it was a good moment, I thought, what is that I have done great? Okay, that, you know, that's the thing first comes. Then you see, the next thing is you have to justify. Okay, leave whatever happened, just you have to justify what is that. And the audience are very general, chemistry, physics, and biology, and even non-academic people. I thought I must choose a topic very consciously, which I do something also. It's not be, you know, very general Google or Wikipedia talk. So I thought frustration, which is a right thing, which I have been doing on many systems. And I thought this is, I can connect immediately to, you know, many of us, because we every day frustration, we go through it to different levels. I thought this must be the first thing I connected to human being colleagues. Then I thought it is frustration is a conflicting interactions. It can exist in everywhere, you know, all systems, chemical system, biological systems, everywhere. Immediately I gave a Google search. Of course, Google comes here. So I just put this word exactly, frustration in biomolecules, because I know they are big molecules. There are many non-covalent interactions and many. So there is a big review article, 100 pages, exactly same title, frustration in biomolecules, 100 pages, okay? So, and I know that is a big molecule, so you have frustration, there are various interactions possible. Also in chemistry, simple water, you take, there is a frustration. So I said, this is the topic I'm going to talk. So I want to engage. I don't know how much I'm going to do my best, but let us see, please stay with me. I'm not going to give a outline of talks, okay? So you should look for the next slide. So more or less, you should be, you know, you should not be frustrated, but let us see. So then, before getting into frustration, I want to thank Professor Rao for bringing me to JNC and providing me all the facilities and interacting with him. We have published a lot of papers together. More than that, apart from science, a lot of things I learned from Professor Rao. Professor Rao, thank you very much for your kind opportunity, and I really enjoy, I've been enjoying, and I look forward to enjoy further. Look at his smiling face. Very pleasant, very attractive. Okay, it is against the frustration. Now look at this person. Very disappointed. Okay, he seems to be frustrated. Okay, so we all know that. So as I said, frustration arises in all interacting systems. Okay, so I can divide this into, emotional response. That is the frustration response of the human being. It's an emotional response in human being. And in materials, I just classified into soft matter, which further divided into biomolecules, chemistry. And just this morning, I learned something. It's called frustrated Lewis pair. Okay. I know what is Lewis as Lewis pair and everything, but not frustrated. I just learned this morning. So it is, I learned really a lot by preparing for this talk. In fact, I would say whether I deserve whatever I have done before for this award, but the amount of effort I put for this and the frustration I had, I deserve it. Okay. So this is what I want to tell. Then I will go to my system, spin system. I will end up the talk, I'll show this. So I would say now saying that frustration is everywhere. Okay. So we need to be only careful. So I want to give you a postulates of frustration in human being. This comes from materials. We need to learn a lot from materials. We are very clever, we think, but it is like taking us to, frustration. But materials are much more clever. There is a frustration means there is a degree of frustration, so it will do only that. But if we know that frustration, we will not be able to do whatever we want. Okay, we will get into various, metastable states. So I just put from my, so it's a disclaimer, okay, it's not coming from anywhere. So it's my own experience and then learn from the materials. So all these things, it can arise from outside, by interacting with many people or within yourself. You can have a conflicting thoughts that can frustrate us, okay? So we can say that I will close my eyes and sit. No, even if you close, you will think different thing and get confused and you have conflicting thoughts. For that, you need to go to meditative state. That is the no thought state, but it's not easy. Materials also, there are certain materials which you cannot find very easily. Okay, I will tell you when I talk about it. Then, so I said conflicting thought leads to frustration, fine. It's unavoidable in our life. It is there. So it is not bad. That's what I wanted to say in my lecture. It is not, frustration is not, everyone should realize it. Yes, there is a frustration. I want to deal with it. Okay. So that is the message. And we should not yield to it. Just don't enjoy the frustration. Okay. But just need to be aware of it and then you will find a solution. Should it arise? Don't respond immediately. All this disorder system, what I say, the frustrated system, slow dynamics. Give ample time. Don't respond immediately, then you'll have problem. So this is all experience. Okay. Should be short-lived. You should not hold this frustration for a long time, get into pressure and go to doctor, all these things. Then need to learn from materials a lot. Materials, as I said, they're very clever. They're not clever, but they know that there is a frustration parameters, certain things they do, certain things clearly. Then metastable state is undesired. There are, I can say that some system in spins or in some other system, there are metastable states. We don't want that. We want minimum, frustration or no frustration state. So we should aim for that. Okay, so I don't know, already 12 minutes, it's too bad. I'm frustrated now. So let me take one example for each one. So frustration in eyes. So eyes, we know all of us, it was, first I'll just mention is that Giot and Stout in 1936, they measured the entropy of water. We'll not go into detail how they measured. They found there is a residual entropy, which means there is a disorder, there is a frustration. Okay. Then came Linus Pauling to explain this. Okay. He accounted what is this entropy comes from, configurational disorder because of the hydrogen positions. That's how it comes from this. Okay, I must use because online people are there. So You have the oxygen ions are, you know, they take their position, lattice positions in the tetrahedra. They form the tetrahedra is a highly frustrated lattice geometry. Then you have oxygen. So each oxygen is surrounded by four, and each hydrogen is surrounded by two oxygen here. And you will see that two oxygens, they are very close to an oxygen, and two oxygens are far. Okay, when you look at the distance, OO distance is 2.76, whereas OH distance is 0.96. They are not in the middle. Okay, so there is clearly there is a disorder, there is a frustration, and that's where Pauling computed the frustration, the residual entropy by using the Boltzmann law, statistical distribution of this oxygen. How, for example, we can have between oxygen and oxygen two position possible. So if you calculate, it comes 16 positions, 16 possible states, but out of that only six is possible because of the constraint of the motor molecule. So if you put that, and what you get calculate compute is residual entropy, which is close to what is observed experimentally. So that explains. So probably that's what people say, that this is the first system in materials to be observed a frustrated material. Okay, so next comes this morning what I learned, that frustrated Lewis pair. Lewis pair is a, you know, a simple explanation. I think I should not go too much. I will not have time. It is between Lewis acid and base, they form a kind of adduct zwitterion. Okay, that is easy. But if you have some bulky molecule attached to it, then it cannot form this. So that is the frustration. That means they like to form certain adduct, but they cannot form because of some reason. So the steric hindrance. So they are frustrated. That's what they use this term frustrated. I think it is correct to use. There is a discussion that whether to use frustration or not. I say that still we can use it because the system want to be in the lowest energy state, but it's not possible due to certain reasons like the steric hindrance. So this is the history goes that, and then just for example, this system does not form the adduct, but when you change this, this is called lutidine. And if we change this to BF3, then you can form the adduct. So that's what rationale comes from here. So it is the steric hindrance. And then there are many things you can possible to use the benzene. In presence of benzene, you can form this adduct between these two molecules, or butadiene and so on. And the first one was clearly explained is the 1996 by Pierce, is the catalysis of keto hydroxylation. Okay, so it's a silicon hydrogen bond formation to the ketone. So this is what they confirm, that there is a frustrated Lewis pair. Okay, so now frustration in biomolecules. The great example is protein folding. I did not know anything more than that, what is protein, which I studied in MSc, that Leninger book. Okay, then I started looking at the 100-page articles, what is the steps involved in protein folding. And I see there are four stages, primary, secondary, tertiary, and quaternary. But there are frustration involved when it reaches. But protein folding happened properly. Sometime, you know, that's what misfolding happens. So I try to, there is a theory called, can you remove that? I don't know, the top. Energy landscape theory. That's called a minimal, based on the minimal frustration. Okay, so this will lead to ultimately to a minimally frustrated rate. You know that I don't have to, you know, explain all this, that how many amino acids are there, you know, they form the alpha helix structure, then side chain interactions, all these things comes, and you know, okay, finally it takes this, for example, hemoglobin is a protein, okay, and the stable protein, that is. So to reach that, it undergoes so many thousands of interactions, conformations. And finally, it reaches what it wants, the system wants. And this is explained by the stats based on the statistical mechanics, this LNG landscape. You can see this is a rugged funnel type landscape, okay, the potential energy surface. So you can see this rugging, you know, this is the metastable states. It can trap to these states. Yeah? But finally, but nature ultimately, it leads to minimal, that is the native state of the protein. So where you have minimally frustrated state, okay? Most of the frustration is gone. So you can see the entropy is very high. And that's what I was there when I started my talk, my entropy was like that. So I need to reach this state in another 30 minutes or 20 minutes. But these molecules, biomolecules, wonderful protein, it takes milliseconds to microseconds to release all the frustration and reach this minimally frustrated state. So it's very nice to learn. In fact, I learned because of this, you know, opportunity to talk. So many things I learned. So it's very nice. Now I come to magnetism. So I have 10 minutes more. Okay, that's good. So now I come to magnetism. Okay, so we talked about soft materials, the frustration. They lead to different structures, disorder, positional disorder, and so on. In magnetism, same thing, spin. Okay, the electron spin, they can interact and they can have a conflicting interactions. It can be frustrated. But when we say, I just for introducing people, so simple paramagnet means all the spins, they don't interact. Like in ideal gas, all the atoms are far away, they don't interact. Okay, but as you reduce the temperature, when the interaction exchange energy dominates over the thermal energy, they undergo this kind of classical ferromagnet like this, or it is called antiferromagnet. So this is the spin structure what your refrigerator magnets, the permanent magnets, has the spin structure like this. And then the antiferromagnet, okay, the net movement is zero. It's very complicated antiferromagnet, okay? So ferromagnetism, all the spins are aligned any one of these holographic axes or plane. But antiferromagnetism, very complex. I have just given in two dimension up and down, but there are various configurations possible and the frustration is more in this system, okay? But of course, there are, it is also possible at certain conditions, frustrations here. And then the last one configuration is ferrimagnet. You can see that up movement, it is basically a combination of both. That means there is an antiferromagnetic interaction up and down, okay? But they are not equal. That means there is a finite movement. So that is equivalent to ferromagnet. So this is, you might have studied in your, you know, the plus two level, the lodestone, naturally occurring magnet, okay? Fe3O4, and the spin structure is like that. Okay, so classically you see there is one more magnetism, is called diamagnetism, which is coming from the orbital motion. So there is no spin, okay, no unpaired electron. So I didn't put anything. So now, so that is the classical magnet the system wants to be, okay? When they take parallel or anti-parallel, they reach the minimum energy. They are happy. So but in many systems, so this is the one of these lattice, like antiferromagnetic structure in square lattice. But the square lattice also, when you distort it, then you can have you know, nearest neighbor, next nearest neighbor, J1, J2, two different interactions that can lead to frustration. So, but without any distortion, the square lattice, you can have this kind of clear collinear antiferromagnet. And this here, antiferromagnetic interaction here, is given by this equation, J, sigma, SISG. This is the spin between the two neighbors, nearest neighbor interactions. So I will quickly go into the frustrating system, okay? When there are frustration in spin system can come due to two reasons. One is dilute magnetic system. Suppose we all are non-magnetic. I put few places in magnetic systems and they have you know, a disordered state and they have this kind of frustrated magnetic system, okay? So you have a spin glass called the ground state, it can appear. So the frustration come from a dilute magnetic system. Or you can have a lattice, this kind of lattice, a triangular lattice. You can take simple triangle and then try to put antiferromagnetic, you are constraining to so-called the icing spin up and down. It can take only either up or down spin. So for example, here you put in this corner, this triangle, you take it and up spin, down spin. Well, they are minimized. This energy is minimized because they are collinear and antiferromagnetic. But you see the third spin, if you put up, this will satisfy this spin, but not this spin, okay? If you put down, it will satisfy this. So this means we say that this system is frustrated, okay? So you have degenerate ground states, depending on what kind of lattice and the spins. So you will see various degenerate, not single minimum energy configuration. So you will have many degenerate. In this case, for example, in the triangle single, you have six-fold degenerate. They will be fluctuating among this. So you have, I think, so this kind of six coming up and down configuration, so each can contribute two. So you have six spin configuration and they are degenerate. Okay, normally you have single minimum energy configuration. So this is because of the frustration. So I will quickly go through it. So you can have this kind of Kagome lattice. Again, it contains triangular lattice, but the connections are different. Okay, so it is connected to the vertices. But here, this can in the previous slide, you can see that it's all connected like this. So this can give you frustration. Then another very important lattice is the pyrocellular lattice. It comes from the pyrocellular mineral. Okay, so this pyrocellular mineral, in this, for example, it is called R2Ti2O7. R means lanthanides or rare earth. So chemists say lanthanide and physics say rare earth. Okay, so the lanthanides series magnetic ions. So they sit on the tetrahedra. So I told you already ice, which is in the tetrahedra position. So it is a frustrated position. So you will have a frustrated interaction. It cannot satisfy all the spins, you know, antiferromagnetic interactions. So that will lead to different, degenerate levels. So now I said in the title, emergent phenomena. So the frustration is there. So what it gives? So that's very important. So in magnetism, so magnetic frustration leads to spin liquid. Okay. Spin liquid, it is like a liquid like situation. Okay. There is no order down to lowest temperature, 0 Kelvin. And all the spins are correlated, strongly correlated. Okay. Like a paramagnetic, but there is an interaction. Okay. Below the Curie Weiss temperature at low temperatures. So, or you can have spin ice. It is similar to ice situation. Okay, there are two hydrogen close to one oxygen and two are far. Similarly, you can have two in spin towards the center of the tetrahedra, two out. Okay, and again, you can have many configurations here. You have a degenerate state here. Okay, and spin ice, it can just freeze in some state. But in this case, it is not possible. That depends on, you know, the what kind of spins, whether it is S equal to half or higher. Okay, whether you consider a classical or quantum spin liquid. So all these things are possible. We are not going to, because this will be a separate talk. There are other phenomena comes out. One is incommensurate magnetic structure. Whatever magnetic structure I told you, ferromagnetic, they are commensurate. That means you have a nuclear cell and the magnetic cell, this also ordered. So, and both are, you know, same. Or you can have multiple integral, multiple 0.5, 0.5 like that. So you can have a commensurate structure, those kind of things, but here you have incommensurate structure. You can see this spin is rotating along the chain, you know, like this, and then going. This is called cycloidal structure. And you can see something similar to alpha helix, that helical structure. Okay, this spin rotates, but perpendicular to the propagation direction, this one. And here you have a spin density wave. Okay, that's a magnitude changes. And that the spin density. So when the incommensurate magnetic structure forms, there are various possibility for the ground state. And this leads to very interesting properties like a spin induced ferroelectricity. Normally ferroelectricity cannot be induced by spin, but this kind of spin break inversion symmetry and induce ferroelectricity at the magnetic transition. But these two are center symmetric. They are not chiral. And it can also do magnetostructural transition. This to relieve the frustration, what it will do, it will distort the structure. Like if you get frustrated with somebody, you damage that person and reduce your frustration. But here it distorts the structure. That means it reduces the frustration and go into the ordering. So that's what happened. There are several examples. That's called a spin Yanteller effect. Okay, Yanteller effect is spontaneous distortion, removal of the degeneracy. But here, the spin is causing that, so that's why we call it spin Yanteller effect. Then there is a spin glass. That's why I said in the beginning, we should not go into spin glass. It's a useless glass, okay? It's like a glass system, the amorphous disorder glass. And the spins are random direction, which can be frozen at below the glass transition. So it's similar to the spin glass. Okay, now we tried, it is not there in the literature. We thought, okay, why don't we do some frustration parameter. This is an empirical relation, F equal to theta, Curie Weiss temperature, and by T, this can be Tn or a T star at low temperature, okay? So this ratio gives you for frustration parameter. We try to look at various systems and then whether we can get something. So we put that if it is F equal to 1, that means collinear magnetic ordering, and then it increases, then moderate, high, and very high, and so on. So put it infinity, my student did, Rahul. So, and then we see the various phenomena where it fits, where it comes. and then moderate spin frustration in commensurate magnetic structures. And then you can see there is no clear boundary. Okay, it's very, we are just trying to do this. And then comes a spin glass, which goes up to 100, then magnetostructural transition, then spin ice, spin liquid. It can be infinity. I told you the spin like is something like a meditative state, no thought state. I don't know, it is possible in human being, if you look at it, we are from one to infinity. Okay, not like they have certain regions. So, but we can still possible to have very high and then damage ourselves. But I don't know whether it is related to, you know, highest frustration and then the spin liquid, what I'm saying is no thought state, which leads to a new state. Okay, I don't know. So, but this leads to a conventional ordering and then it goes to unconventional phenomena like this. So, I just want to tell you that spin liquid in magnetism, what happens? Some example. So, highly correlated and fluctuates strongly down to lowest temperature, 0 Kelvin. There's no ordering. People, there are not many systems known to exhibit this phenomena. The problem is first to get spin liquid, and because some disturbance or distortion or perturbation can lead to different ground state, like a spin glass ground state or structural transition, something. So it is very difficult to get spin liquid state, and also it is very difficult to experimentally verify it. There are theories, okay? And highly correlated and fluctuates strongly down to lowest temperature. There is no long range interaction. However, when you apply magnetic field or high pressure, you can see some ordering. And long range quantum entanglement, okay? So that's a very good thing, that there is a quantum entanglement between the spins at greater distance. And fractionalized excitations, these are proposed from the theory, okay? As I said, absence of magnetic ordering. And there are lattices like this. They can take the fluctuating degenerate states, and there's no ordering, basically. They just fluctuate. So it is also predicted that, you know, possible application in quantum computing and so on. So there is a long way to go in this problem of spin liquid. Spin ice, I already told you, the pyrochlore system, where the tetrahedrons are cornered or vertex shared. So you get two in and two out system, and people have measured the entropy in this system experimentally in one of the system, DY2TU207, and they see that there is a residual entropy, falling entropy, what is seen in ice. So this is slightly different from the spin liquid. So I told you spin-induced structural transition. So at high temperature, for example, this system is tetragonal with space group, but this is system is frustrated. This has a spirochlore lattice, and then there is a diamond lattice. Both are frustrated lattice. But if you put magnetic ions in both sides, there are frustration, but the interaction between A and B is not frustrated. It is close to 180 degree, okay? So at high temperature, it forms a ferrimagnetic ground state like this. But as you decrease the temperature, the dominations of this tetrahedra, that means the pyrochlore lattice, this one octahedra, they are connected here. And then these are all the oxygen octahedra, but what I'm saying about metal, which form tetrahedra. Those tetrahedra frustration dominates, so it distorts the structure to tetragonal. You can see elongation of this. Okay, at the same temperature, it undergoes spin, changes spin structure. So it goes from a collinear ordering to helical structure, which is typical of frustrated system. Okay, but it goes to the ground state is a helical system. Okay, so then spin glass. So I said it has a lot of metastable states, and the spins will be frozen because the competing ferromagnetic, antiferromagnetic interactions. So below the glassy glass transition, it can freeze into a local minimum state, and it undergoes paramagnetism to a spin glass state. And we can do a lot of experiment to confirm whether it is spin glass or not. I will not go into detail. I think I have less. So another 5 minutes? 5 minutes, fantastic. So this is what at the end of the thing, that incommensurate structure, what we are looking for, to induce spin-induced ferroelectricity. So these are all possible spin density wave, which is centrosymmetric, and a cycloidal, which breaks inversion symmetry. So we look for this kind of spin. These all we can determine from neutron diffraction. Okay. So, and then helical structure, even helical structure can be made to induce polarization at certain conditions. So, but today I will not go into it. There is also conical spin structure possible, transverse or longitudinal conical structures. So these kind of things possible. So we have been working on recently, again, this perovskite is a but doubly ordered perovskite. Perovskite is a ABO3 structure. What we did is in the A cation, we replaced two ions instead of trivalent. You put instead of bivalent, you put a monovalent and trivalent. So these ions will order alternatively, okay, like a rock salt sodium chloride structure. The same way you can do it in the B site also. But in this case, you have a layered ordering of A site. So these are all the A site sodium and this yellow or lanthanum, for example. Here it is yttrium. Okay, so it is sodium. So here yellow is sodium and yttrium is this one. So you have a layered ordering along the one axis, C axis. But at the B site, you have a rock salt ordering of manganese and tungsten. Here the magnetic ion is manganese. Okay, these are the local structures surrounding the. So if you want to have a magnetic interaction, this manganese has to interact with this oxygen, tungsten, oxygen, then again manganese. Okay, but if you look at this structure, it is again frustrated structure, moderately frustrated structure. So, and we measure the physical properties because we were looking for that. So in this material, what is that? It's a ferroelectricity below the magnetic ordering temperature. So this is the magnetic ordering temperature. You can see the delta P, this is a polarization, electric polarization, which appears below Tn. Okay, now we need to explain why this is coming. So we need to understand the magnetic structure. So we did in two compound, one is nickel, another is manganese. Okay, so this is the neutron diffraction pattern collected from ICES UK, and then you need to model. It's not so easy because of this non-collinear spin structure, incommensurate structure. But we have learned many things, last several years. And then if you look at the low temperature stress structure at 1.5 Kelvin, for example, it goes to collinear structure and, it repeats double the unit cell on the x-axis, zero, it doesn't repeat. And then in the z-axis, it is again two times. So you can see there's an antiferromagnetic collinear structure. And just below Tn, at this temperature here, close to 20 Kelvin, you can see the spin. They are antiferromagnetic, but you can see the moment variation is there. Okay, this is an antiferromagnetic spin density wave. It's a very unusual. Normally, spin density wave will be ferromagnetic. For example, all the spins will be up here, and then after this zero moment, the down will be all the ferromagnetic but pointing down. That's called normal spin, conventional spin density wave. But here, the neighboring spins are alternating. Also, the magnitude is changing. So it is a very unusual thing we observe, and we try to explain this based on this. There are two cycloids, okay, that superimpose to give you spin density, whether it can be transverse or longitudinal kind of spin density wave. So what we observe is a transverse, but it's an antiferromagnetic spin density wave. Okay, so it can be the ground state can be either cycloidal or spin density wave, or it can be helical. So there are several other parameters which plays, like a magnetic anisotropy and so on. So in nickel case, it is antiferromagnetic spin density wave, like what you see here. So antiferromagnetic spin density wave. But well, lot of calculations it was done, DFT calculation to see the exchange parameters and what is responsible for this kind of structure. I will not go into detail. So these are the exchange constant. There are 9 different exchanges. So obviously frustration. Okay. So and then the manganese system, what we see is a helical, again antiferromagnetically coupled neighbors, but it's a helical. It's a, it rotates, but it is perpendicular to the propagation direction. So there is a difference between nickel and manganese that we try to understand, that because of this anisotropy in this manganese, that makes the difference, the helix instead of spin density wave. So I think I should not take too much time. As you finish, these are the students, my group, who have contributed in various ways, and the collaborators, particularly, to understand. I'm not giving, including everybody, but specific to the problems which I shown here, and hexagonal, say, that is, and the funding sources from various things. And finally, I want to conclude saying that frustration is wonderful.
Well, thank you, Professor Sundaresan.
I'm in the minimal frustrated
Not
state.
Yet, though.
No, I'm already.
So, yeah, I noticed that such profound, complex ideas we brought out using very simple analogies for the sake of students. So it has been a nice presentation. Thank you. So we'll take, before we release you completely out of your frustration, a few questions.
Yes.
So from the student group here, anyone among the newly admitted?
Yeah. Yeah.
On the you?
Yeah, in materials, it may not be useful, but it may not be useful the way you expect that. For example, spin glass, as I said, I don't see any usefulness of the spin glass, the ground state. No, there are many other phenomena which are good. For example, I told you incommensurate spin structure, which comes from the frustration, and it gives you new phenomena. It breaks inwards and it becomes chiral and induce ferroelectricity and so on. Yeah.
Please.
So I was just wondering, like, how are the average properties of the material, like the structural properties that engineers simply use, Young's modulus, Poisson's ratio. So in a state of stress, like, does this also play a role?
Well, that's what I missed. I was thinking that I missed. I didn't have time to touch upon that, you know, to go into this. But I think there are frustrating things, but I cannot tell you right now. Okay.
Yeah, please.
Hello. Hello, sir. Wonderful talk. I'm sorry if I sound silly. I'm from engineering background. My primary just one question is, are frustrated states and metastable states, can we call frustrated states as metastable states?
You know, frustrated state, obviously, they are at the high energy state. Okay. So it can end in a metastable state, but if when it relaxes, it can go into the minimum frustration or no frustrated state.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you.
That's by the way, that was a good question.
Yeah. So can the first frustrated systems be used to carry out certain chemical reactions? Say we can create catalysts that are frustrated.
I told you that frustrated Lewis pass, Lewis
yes.
and the base, it is really for that catalysis actually.
Hydrogenation.
Yeah. Hydrogenation and several other molecule, catalysis.
Are there any transition metal complexes in solid state that are frustrated and are used for catalysts?
Well, I don't know the frustration in those catalysts, but I just this morning I studied that Lewis, frustration.
Thank you, sir.
I don't know.
Anyone among the oldest students of science, faculty colleagues? No.
They don't want to.
Online, we have two more minutes. Yeah, Ashikan, yes.
Now this is a comment about what you said about spin glasses. Half seriously, the study of spin glasses is what led to us appreciating the concept of frustration. So I guess it had some use.
That's what I said. It came much before in ICE. I don't know when it was realized the first time in ICE. Interestingly, in biomolecules, with the paper I mentioned, the introduction, they discuss about the magnetic frustration, and then they go into biological system, biomolecules. Yeah.
Professor Vidyadhiraj, use your microphone in front.
Yeah, just continuing on the same thing. So there are several neural network models which are actually spin glass models. So you can learn a lot about how neurons interact and how information or how you can model neural networks using spin glasses. So there is some use.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you. And we need to study a lot. I know spin glass itself is huge.
And
those who are online, you may unmute your microphone and speak one by one, if at all. Anyone is wanting to ask question? I saw something popping up here. You may just read out, please, whoever it is. Okay, maybe you can interact. Okay, who is this from? Sushank Chaturvedi, to everyone, not just to the speaker. Does Shashank, yeah, Shashank, does the phonon mode frequency, yeah, is there? Does the phonon mode frequency in these type of systems are of the order of exchange interactions?
Exchange interactions are very, very, I think it's much more higher than the phonon modes. I don't know whether any case where comparable, it's maybe it's possible that the structural transition which undergoes, you know, the exchange, I don't know whether Umesh can comment.
I think since I know him as my student, his question probably means that he pointed out the quantum spin fluctuations leading to spin liquid state. He's comparing those 0-point fluctuations.
Ah, okay, okay.
Whether they can sort of lead to an interesting structure and masses.
Yeah.
Okay, so I think we are done with the questions. Sundar, I have a very pleasant duty to perform. I'm coming to the stage.
Coming to the stage.
I hope I deserve. Thank you.
Let us thank the awardee, Professor Sundaresan, and also Professor Rao for the award itself. Thank you very much. We're closing this session now.
Thank you very much, Professor Kulkarni, and also Professor Sundaresan for a very nice talk in a manner which is accessible to all the audience here. So it's a tradition in JNCSR. Annually, we welcome our new students in an event which is following the CNRR Oration Award lecture. So it's my pleasure, duty now to conduct the next part of this event today. And I'm really glad to say we are lucky to have Bharat Ratna Professor CNR Rao amongst us to grace us this occasion, along with the President Professor Kulkarni, who will be speaking to us very soon. Just to give you a little statistics, in January 2021, 6 students joined. 5 of them are PhD students and 1 of them are master's students. And in this session, which is September 2021, we have 64 students joining us. So the total strength of students joining this year, 2021, we have 37 admissions to PhD program, 17 admissions to integrated PhD programs, 6 admissions to MS engineering program, and 6 to MSc chemistry, and finally 4 admissions to postgraduate diploma in material science program. This also shows us the diversity of programs at JNCSR. This year the number of admissions is a bit on a higher side, but we are really happy that in spite of pandemic, we are only delayed by 1 month in bringing you back to the campus and having this session today. So it's now my pleasure duty to invite Professor Kulkarni, the president of JNCSR, to make formal address for welcoming you all.
Thank you, Professor Vaghmare. My dear students, on behalf of the center, on behalf of my colleagues, I extend a warm welcome to you all. I should congratulate each of you, 64 of you, for your selection to the program you are admitted to after the rigorous process you have been through. I must say you have joined the right place. JNCSR is one among the top institutions in the country. As a research institution and also as a deemed to be university recognized by UGC. JNC has earned all important recognitions, I must say, nationally and also internationally. Beyond that, every year our center, our faculty members, students also bag many distinguished awards and accolades. So I congratulate you again for having become a member of this prestigious family. In this center, we carry out mostly basic research activities in several diverse areas, and also any of the inventions born out of your work, we don't stop with just a publication. We make attempts to take them forward through the translational activities, through patenting and whatnot, and also working with industry. We explore the potential benefits of the invention to the society. So that's also an important path. During your period here, you must get exposed to and have some experience translating your own inventions. My colleagues take part in conducting many important national and international conferences within the campus and sometimes outside, involving colleagues from abroad. Our collaborative network is widespread across virtually all the institutions in India. I mean, many, many important institutions in India, IITs, IISc, ICER, so on and so forth, and also many, many important places across the continents. So we are extremely well connected, and we collaborate with many important people and bring out joint inventions and publications. If you look at the numbers, we bring out collectively around 300 publications every year, research articles every year in really reputed journals. That goes to say it amounts to one per every student. We have around 300-350 students, one per student per year. Okay, that's a reasonable number. So again, if you translate it in terms of what you gain through this process, what feeds into your curriculum vitae is that by the time you finish the PhD, the student would be authoring, anyone could be authoring a few publications, could be one, two, you know, there are people who have published 12, 15 also, depending on the research area and the kind of difficulties they came across, how they circumvented. There are lots of factors actually get into play. So it's good to have at least one publication for the PhD degree. And also possibly one or two patents, you know, that also carries some weight. And if you list out that you did participate in one or two important conferences, that will be a good addition too. In fact, UGC itself has laid out the norms, guidelines for universities, what the student should be gaining during the PhD program. And without saying, our students also earn a lot of awards on the path to their degree. The idea of JNCSR, you may find that it is a very unique place. You know, if you look around, it's not truly like an university. It is much smaller in size, and it contains the small units, not big departments, and each unit is focusing on some frontier area, right? And each unit has its own research areas, and you know, wanting to bring out very important findings, working with colleagues, working with industry, in independent, faculty-driven small groups. The founder of the center, Professor C.N.R. Rao, had this vision, foresight, zeal and dedication, I must say. Okay, over the last 25, 30 years, the way he has brought up this center on very strong foundation on which our we have the success what we see today. Having said so, you having become the member of this family, your views are always welcome. And we expect you to take active contributions in all the vibrant activities we have on campus. And as you proceed with your degree programs, PhD or master's or whatever, even master's students also end up getting one or two publications, those who are active and have a research project to attend to. So I must say that your path may not be straight and smooth, okay? It can be quite bumpy at times, but be assured that you are well guided. Do remember that at JNCSR, we have a very good support system backed by counselors, and my door is always open. You can approach me in case of any difficulty. And for all of us in the among the faculty and also in the administration, what is important is your well-being. It is of utmost importance. So I take this occasion to thank Dean Professor Vagmare and Coordinator Dr. Selvam for their efforts to take through the admission process. This year also, it was not less challenging. And I also thank my colleague instructors who will be conducting various courses through this semester. So once again, a warm welcome to you all and wish you the best. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Kulkarni. Now, the last part of this event is to introduce all the new students who have joined us in January and September session this year. For that, I just want to say, if any of the new students are standing at the entrance of this hall, can I request you to come forward and sit inside, please? The seating is with priority to the new students, not the senior students of the center. So if some of us can make space for them, that will be very kind of you. Please come in, because now we will have introduction of each of you. So it's good if we all can see you. We are, of course, joined by a number of participants online to see you. So okay, thank you. So what we will do is I'll call upon name of each of you one by one, and I request you to get up when your name comes up and tell us where you come from, which is the last degree that you got before joining JNC, and what subject that degree was in, which university you studied in, and finally, which group at JNCSR you will be working with if you are a PhD student. If not, you don't have to mention the last part. Okay, let's get started. First, I'll call upon the names of students who joined us in January 2021. First student is Akhilesh Srivastava. He joined MS Engineering in Engineering Mechanics Unit. Is he with us? Yeah. If not, we move on to the next. Shubham Banerjee. He joined PhD program in EMU, working with K.R. Srinivas. If the student is not present here, I will read out some information about him. Butch Rimkar Bhargava. Yes. Yeah.
My name is Rimkar, and I joined in January in Molecular Biology and Genetics Unit under Professor Uday Kumar Ranga as a PhD student. Thank you. I'm from Gujarat. Thank
you. Shobhit Suresh.
Good afternoon, all. My name is Shobhit Suresh. I'm from Kerala. I've done my master's in virology from Amity University, Noida. Currently, I'm doing my PhD under the guidance of Professor Uday Kumar Ranga.
Thank you. Subham Das, who joined NCU. Yes. Yes.
Good afternoon to all of you.
Just make sure you unmute yourself on that speaker, so that while we can hear you, the people online should also be able to hear you.
Yes, this on. Good afternoon to all of you. Myself Shubham Das from West Bengal. I did my MSc Chemistry from Banaras Hindu University, BHU. I joined JNC in January under Professor Ranjali Vishwanathalab as a PhD student.
Thank you.
Bhuvaneshwari
R.
I'm Bhuvaneshwari R. I am a BTech graduate of 2020 batch in Electronics and Communication Engineering from Sasha Deem Thiru University, Tamil Nadu. I'm currently working under the guidance of Professor Umesh Vagmare, and I'm happy to be a part of JNCSR to pursue my PhD.
Thank you. Yeah. Now we move on to the students who joined us in September session of this year. First set of students are the PhD students, NCU, PhD program in NCU. Papiya Sadhu.
So good afternoon, everyone. I am Papiya Sadhu. I came from West Bengal. I did my master's in Jadavpur University, Kolkata. And here I joined Professor Shubhijor's group for pursuing my PhD program. Thank you.
V. Manikandan.
Good morning to all present here. Myself, I am Manikandan. I completed my MSc from American College. It is affiliated to Madurai Kamaraj University, and I have joined Professor Govindraju sir for pursuing my PhD. Thank you.
Kriti K. Bhagwat. Nandini Saha.
Am I audible? Good afternoon, sir. Myself Nandini Saha.
Vaishali Taneja. Can we have one more microphone running around, please?
Am I audible?
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Vaishali Taneja. I'm from Delhi. I have done my master's in chemistry from IIT Roorkee. I have joined JNCSR for my PhD program under Professor Kanishk Biswas, New Chemistry Unit.
Nilutpal Datta.
Hello. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Nilutpal. I have completed my master's from IIT Hyderabad. Here I have joined Professor Sebastian Peters Left for my PhD. Thank you.
Soumya Panja.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am Soumya Panja. I am from West Bengal, and I have done my MSc degree from Banaras Hindu University, and recently I am joining here in the lab of Professor Ranjani Viswanathan in NCU department as a PhD student. Thank you.
Sushanta Shaw.
Hello, I am Sushanta Shaw from West Bengal. I recently completed my MSc in chemistry from Banaras Hindu University. Here I joined as a PhD student under the supervision of Dr. Sarita Agusti lab.
Debashri Bora.
Hello everyone, myself Debashri Bora. I completed my master degree from University of Hyderabad. Now I have joined Professor Banikanto Sharma sir's lab as a PhD student. Thank you.
Shubhankar Maiti.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Shubhankar Maiti. I am from West Bengal. I did my MSc from IIT Madras. Here I have joined Professor Jayanta Haldar's lab for my PhD. Thank you.
And lastly, Anshu Lata.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am Anshu Lata. I'm from Rajasthan. I did my MSc from IIT Madras. Here I joined the Dr. Manikanta Sharma lab for my PhD. Thank you.
Yeah, now I will call upon the names of students who have joined PhD program in the Theoretical Sciences Unit of the Center. Anjaneya Pati Tripathi.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Anjaneya Pati Tripathi. I am from Uttar Pradesh. I did my MSc Physics from Gorakhpur University. I am here for PhD under Subir Kedas in TSU department.
Swaranendu Maiti.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am Swaranendu Maiti from West Bengal. I have done my MSc from IIT Bhubaneswar, and I have here joined under Professor Srikant Sastri's lab in TSU. Thank you.
Debarga Sarkar.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am Debarga Sarkar. I have done my master's from Ramakrishna Mission Vivekananda University in physics, and I have joined Professor Srikant Shastri's lab in TSU this year.
Mayank Sharma.
Good afternoon, everyone. Myself, Mayank Sharma. I have done my BSc and MSc from Banaras Hindu University in physics, and here in JNCSR, I have joined as a PhD student under the guidance of Sopan K. Pati.
Lakshita.
Hello everyone, my name is Lakshita. I am from Punjab. I did my MS degree in physics from ICER Mohali. I joined JNC in PhD program under Dr. Kavita Jain. Thank you.
Sayan Paul.
Hello everyone, I am Sayan Paul from West Bengal. I did my MSc from Banaras Hindu University, and here I have joined in TSU under the guidance of Sapan Pothi.
Sayantan Maiti.
Hello everyone, I am Sayantan from Kanchi, West Bengal.
I did my MSc in IISER Kolkata in physics. Here I have joined Professor Kavita Jain's lab in the PhD.
Kushal Samanta. No, Kushal has joined PhD program in TSU to work with Professor Shobhana Narasimhan. We'll now call upon the names of students who joined PhD program in Chemistry and Physics of Materials Unit. Athira MP.
I am joining Dr.
Sarita Sarasvati
as a PhD student.
Soumili Chowdhury.
Am I audible? Good afternoon, everyone. I am Soumili Chowdhury. I am from West Bengal. I did my master's from IIT Madras, and now I have joined here in CPMU for my PhD under the guidance of Professor Tapesh Kumar Majhi sir. Thank you.
Saurav Rudra.
Am I audible?
Yeah.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am Saurav Rudra and I am from West Bengal, Kolkata. And I did my master's in physics from Jadavpur University. And in JNCSR, I have joined the Dr. Biba Shah's lab, CPMU.
Sahaj Sharma.
So, hello all. This is Sahaj. I'm from West UP, Mujaffarnagar, and I did my master's in chemistry from IIT Guwahati. And here I joined as a PhD student under supervision of Professor Tapas Majhi. Thank you.
Now we will call upon the names of students who joined PhD program in Molecular Biology and Genetics Unit. Chinta Patla Sri Charan.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Sri Charani. I'm from Hyderabad. I completed my master's from University of Calicut in biotechnology. I joined Professor Anuranjan Anand sir's lab for PhD.
Sorry, I misspelled your name. Sri Krishna K.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Krishna. I am from Karnataka. I did my master's from CHG Bengaluru, affiliated to Mysore University in genetics. I joined Professor Kausasan's lab as a PhD student. Thank you.
Now the students who joined PhD program in Neurosciences Unit, Manasi Rathi.
Hello everyone, I'm Manasi Rathi. I'm from Delhi. I've done Masters in Zoology from Delhi University and I've joined Shiba Vasu ma'am's lab in Neuroscience Unit.
Nilapwan Roy Chowdhury.
Hello everyone. My name is Nilpavan Roy Chowdhury. I am from Assam. I did my master's in zoology from University of Delhi, and I did I joined in PhD under Professor James Celia.
Lastly, we have students who joined PhD program in Evolutionary and Integrative Biology Unit. I called their names last because I was told they were busy in some class. So I hope they have joined us here now. Monish Singh.
Am I audible?
Yes.
Hello, everyone. Good afternoon. I'm Monish Singh. I'm from Lucknow. I've done my master's in zoology from Lucknow University, and I've joined under Professor Amitabh Joshi at the EBL, EIBU.
Jabili Chowdhury.
Hi everyone, my name is Jabili Chowdhury. I am from Andhra Pradesh, Visakhapatnam. I did my master's in environmental science from Central University of Punjab. I've joined at Professor TNC Vidya's lab, EIB.
Divya Chowdhury.
Hello everyone, my name is Divya. I'm from Rajasthan and I've joined as a PhD student under Professor TNC Vidya in EIB.
Bhavana.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Bhavna. I'm from Rajasthan. I did my master's from Hyderabad Central University in biochemistry, and I've joined Professor Amitabh Joshi lab in EIBU. Thank you.
There has been one admission to PhD program in the Engineering Mechanics Unit this session. His name is Abhishek Ganguly.
Hello. So, good afternoon. My name is Abhishek Ganguly, and I am from New Delhi. I hold a master's in technology program in thermal engineering from National Institute of Technology, Durgapur. I have joined the Engineering Mechanics Unit for my PhD, and I'll be working under the guidance of Professor Mehboob Alam, sir. Thank you.
Now I'll call upon the names of the students who have joined integrated PhD programs at the center. Here, typically students who complete their BSc join in this program. So first is the program in biological sciences, Priyesh Singh Parihar.
Hello, this is Priyesh Singh Parihar. I am from Rewa, Madhya Pradesh. I did my bachelor's from Banaras Hindu University Zoology Department. Yes, sir. And I joined integrated PhD course in MBGU.
Joy Bhattacharya.
Hello everyone. My name is Joy Bhattacharya. I'm from Kolkata. I did my bachelor's from Presidency University, Kolkata in life sciences. And I joined JNCSR as an integrated PhD student in biological sciences.
Priyadarshani Ghosh.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am Priyadarshini Ghosh, and I am from Kolkata, West Bengal. I did my BSc in Botany Honours from Lady Brabourne College, Kolkata, Calcutta University. And here I have joined as integrated PhD student in biological sciences. Thank you.
Kamakshi Tomar.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am Kamakshi. I am from Delhi NCR. I did my bachelor's in biomedical science honors from Acharya Narendra Dev College, Delhi University, and I've joined here in integrated PhD program in biological sciences. Thank you.
Now we'll introduce the students who joined in PhD program in chemical sciences. Tamagna Mandal.
Hello everyone. I am Tamagna Mandal. I am from Haldia, West Bengal, and I have done my bachelor's in chemistry from Jadavpur University, and I am here for integrated PhD in NCU.
Gitaunsh.
Hello everyone, I am audible?
Yes.
I am Gitaunsh. I am from Hisar, Haryana. I did my BSc degree from Guru Jambeshwar University, Hisar, and I am here from pursuing my integrated PhD in NCU. Thank you.
Paritra Naha.
Hello everyone, I am Aritra Naha. I am from West Bengal, Kolkata, and I have done my bachelor's in chemistry from Presidency University, Kolkata, and I am here for the integrated PhD program at NCU. Thank you.
Shenar Prahlad Shankar.
Good afternoon. My name is Prahlad Shenoy. I am from Mumbai. I completed my BSc in chemistry from Vivekananda Education Society affiliated to the Mumbai University, and I am here for my integrated PhD in chemistry.
Debaranjan Hati.
Hello everyone, myself Debaranjan Hathi. I'm from Midnapur, West Bengal. I did my graduation in Midnapur College, Autonomous. I'm joining NCU as an integrated PhD student. Thank you.
Shubha Biswas.
Hello everyone, my name is Shubha Biswas, and I am from Habra, West Bengal, and I did my BSc from Sri Chaitanya College, Habra, and I have joined NCU for integrated PhD program. Thank you.
Ayan Fukon. Here.
Hello everyone, my name is Oyan Fukon. I am from Dibrugarh, Assam. I did my bachelor's in chemistry honors from Cotton University, Guwahati, and I am joining as an in PhD student in NCU. Thank you.
Shreyasri Sain. Okay, I think she's supposed to join on anytime this one of these days. Was supposed to report on September 6th. Now we will have students who have joined INT PhD program in material science. Soham Das.
Hello, I'm Soham. I did my BSc chemistry honors from St. Xavier's College, Kolkata, and I have joined the integrated PhD program in material science. Department. Thank you.
Soumya Satpathy.
Hello, everyone. I'm Soumya. I'm from Jharkhand, West Bengal. I have completed my BSc from Midnapur College, West Bengal in physics. I'm joining here in the CPMA unit as a material science student.
Sakshi Verma.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Sakshi Verma. I'm from Delhi. I did my bachelor's in physics honors from Delhi University, and I'm here for integrated PhD program in material science. Thank you.
Utkarsh Singh.
Hello, everyone.
गुड आफ्टरनून, आई एम उत्कर्ष सिंह फ्रॉम गया बिहार. आई डिड माय बीएससी मेजर इन केमिस्ट्री फ्रॉम बिरला इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी रांची एंड आई एम हेयर फॉर इंटीग्रेटेड पीएचडी मटेरियल साइंस एट सीपीएमए. थैंक यू.
राहुल सिंह रावत. ओके, ही इज सपोज्ड टू रिपोर्ट ऑन 7 व्हिच इज yesterday but not yet here. Okay, now I'll call upon the people who joined center in the last 2 days are probably in quarantine, which is why they can't be here with us. The students who joined MS engineering program in the engineering mechanics unit, Akash Bansal.
I am basically from Punjab. My bachelor's is in mechanical engineering from Punjab University, Chandigarh. Okay, so currently here I am for MS engineering program under Santosh Hansmani sir in operations team.
Jishnu Goswami.
Hello everyone, myself Jishnu Goswami. I am from Assam. I did my bachelor's in mechanical engineering department and here in JNCSR I am working under Professor Mehboob Alam in experimental in
Thank you. Manoj Tanaji Tanagawa.
Hello, my name is Manoj Tangawade. I'm from Maharashtra. I completed my BE, Bachelor of Engineering in Mechanical Domain. Here I am for MS Engineering course under K.R. Srinivas, sir.
Thank you. Sorry, your last name was cut out in this printout. Sorry. Ganesh Kumar B.
Hello everyone, I'm Ganesh Kumar. I'm from Coimbatore, Tamil Nadu. I completed my mechanical engineering degree from PhD College, Coimbatore, and I will be working under the guidance of Professor Mehboob Alam in engineering mechanics. Thank you.
Guru Prasad S.
Hello everyone, good afternoon. I'm Guru Prasad. I did my bachelor's in aerospace engineering from NMIT. I'm currently in the EMU for MS engineering program under Professor Divakar. Thank you.
Thank you. Now I'll call upon the names of students who have joined 2 years MSc program in chemistry, which is conducted by the new chemistry unit of the center. Arpita Panda.
Hello everyone, I am Arpita Panda. I am from West Bengal. I did my BSc in chemistry in Bankura University. I am here for MSc chemistry in NCU unit.
Amrendu Kumar Gupta.
Hello everyone, my name is Amrin Kumar Gupta. I did my bachelor's from Banaras Hindu University. I am from UP. I joined NCU as an MSc student. Thank you.
Jatin Chauhan.
Hello everyone, I am Jatin Chauhan. I am from Muradabad, Uttar Pradesh, and I did my BSc degree in PCM from Motilal Nehru College, Delhi University, and I am here for MSc chemistry.
Ramajay Kumar V.
Hello everyone, this is V. Ramjai Kumar from Tamil Nadu. I did my bachelor's in chemistry in Government Arts College, Salem, Tamil Nadu, and I am here for MSc chemistry at NCU. Thank you.
Kashish Kumar Taneja. He is reporting on 8, which is, so he won't be here with us in this hall. K. Palani Ganesh.
Hello, good afternoon everyone. This is K. Palani Ganesh and I am from Madurai, Tamil Nadu. I did my bachelor's degree from American College, which is applicated under Madurai Kamaraja University, and I'm here for to do my master's program in chemistry under MSc.
Lastly, I'll call upon the names of students who have joined the postgraduate diploma program in material science. Chirag Sarthi, J.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Chirag Sarthi. I'm here for the PGDMS program under Professor G. U. Kulkarni's lab, and I have completed my master's in physics from Christ University, Bangalore. Thank you.
Kamlesh Mishra. He's not here. He's going to work with Professor Rajesh Ganapati in ICMS. Chiku Parida.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Chiku Parida. I am from Puri, Odisha. I have completed my master's degree from Indian Institute of Technology, BHU Varanasi, and here joined PGDMS program under supervision of Professor Sovana Nasimhan. Thank you.
And lastly, Nupur Vijay Sonatakke.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am Nupur Sonatakke. I am from Nagpur, Maharashtra. I did my BSMS in physics from ISO Pune. I have joined Professor Kanishka Bishwas lab for PGDNs.
Thank you. Thanks all the new students for introducing to us, and also all the participants who are with us here as well as online, particularly Professor Siena Rao, who has blessed this occasion with his presence. It's indeed, you clear from the introductions, we have students from all parts of India, you know, and it really remarkably represents the diversity of the center. This session of admission, the fraction of students who are girl students is slightly lower than normal, and that's not because fewer girls were admitted, but more because we had higher rejection rates from the girl students this year. Unfortunately, it could be linked with the COVID or the ongoing situation in the country, but indeed we are very thankful to the administration of the center, particularly Professor Kulkarni and his teams, who have worked very hard in making sure our campus is safe to host you and join us so early in this academic year, and with minimal delay of about a month. I also take this opportunity to request all the new members of the society here, the community, that please take responsibility of maintaining this beautiful campus, making it more beautiful. Secondly, following the COVID appropriate behavior in the orientation program, I have already told you the basic fundamental rules, which are meant not only for you individually, but for the health of our community. So please take charge of it. And I wish you all the best in your next few years at the center. And as Professor Kulkarni mentioned, the entire center is student centric. So if you have any issues, you are most welcome to approach any one of us and seek help if necessary, but make sure you get the maximum out of your stay in the center in terms of what your expectations are in terms of academics or other sort of achievements that you want to have as your target in the next few years. And I thank my colleague, Dr. Paniselvam, who is behind this entire program for coordination and organizing all the logistics and details. And I will conclude this program here by thanking once again all of you and Professor Kulkarni and Professor Siena Rao. Thanks one and all, and have a wonderful day.